Okay, so students, next topic is exchange of gases. So when we talk about exchange of gases, and if I am talking about aerobic respiration, then in different organisms, they need for, because aerobic respiration is the major source of energy. As I told you, in yeast and in muscles, these anaerobic respiration takes place rarely. But generally in organisms, aerobic respiration takes place because we are surrounded by oxygen around us, right? So exchange of gases in the case of aerobic respiration, we need continuous supply of oxygen, and in we also exhale carbon dioxide, right? That is unwanted gas from our body, right? Now different organisms have different ways of taking in the oxygen. So if we talk about a simple organism, unicellular organisms or simple organisms, then they have, the mechanism is known as diffusion, right? But if I talk about plants, they are the complex one, but still they use the process of diffusion. So simple organisms and even plants have the process of diffusion. So by the help process of diffusion, they take in the air, the required air, and release the unwanted air. And diffusion is movement of air from high concentration to low concentration, right? So when we talk about the complex animals, more complex animals, and in from animal kingdom, then they have different ways of taking in the required gas, and that is, they have respiratory system. So the complex organisms have respiratory system for the for taking in the oxygen. So the in the, for example, gills in the case of fish, lungs in the case of terrestrial organism like us, human being, even some organisms have skin. They also use their skin for the for taking in the required gas and using it for the respiration. Now here one question, there are questions that why the breathing rate is slow in the case of terrestrial organisms. Why their breathing rate is slow and why the breathing rate of fish or aquatic organism is high? That is because the in the case of fish, the oxygen is dissolved inside the water, right? So oxygen is dissolved inside the water. So to take in that oxygen and to filter out that oxygen using it requires more of effort. Whereas in the case of terrestrial organism, they are surrounded by oxygen, a lot of plenty of oxygen. So they don't need to put that much of effort to get the oxygen continuously. So that's why the answer of this question is that because of the dissolved form of the oxygen inside the water and more effort is required than in case of terrestrial organisms. Now we'll talk about the respiratory system of a more complex organism, and that is human beings, right? So to get a basic idea, what is our main respiratory organ is lung, and we take in oxygen and release CO2, right? Now how do we take place? So basic idea is the air moves from the nostril to the nasal passage, right? From the nasal passage it enters into the trachea. Please note down this flowchart. From trachea it moves to the bronchi, then into the bronchioles, then from bronchioles it moves to the alveoli, and then further enters the bloodstream. Now this is the entry of the oxygen, and from here the exit of the CO2 also takes place in similar manner, right? Now how does it take place? So in the nostril, nostrils are what? These are the openings of the nose, right? Then the passage, I've just missed out one component, two components of the ear. They are pharynx and larynx. So larynx is also known as voice box or starting of the windpipe, right? So pharynx is food pipe and then larynx is windpipe, then into the trachea, then bronchi. So this part is basically part of lung. Trachea, bronchi, bronchiole, yeah. So if we talk about the, even trachea is also outside the lung. When the it is from bronchi, the lungs, the bronchi is tubule which enters inside the lung, and further more of its network is known as, further narrow tubes are known as bronchiole. Then it enters finally into the alveoli. So if we talk about lungs, right? So this is trachea, and this moves inside the different parts of the lungs. These are bronchi. So this is bronchi. These are bronchioles, and they further form, enter inside the sac-like structure, which are known as alveoli. Now the alveoli is actually, if you see the diagram of respiratory system inside your, in your NCRT, then you can easily see that this particular thing is covered with capillaries, so that it can easily the oxygen can be taken in by the bloodstream, and CO2 can be easily given out into the alveolar sac for the exhalation. And then there are outside there are bloodstream, so the required gas enters inside the bloodstream, moves into the different part of the body, and then different cells, and from cells then cells utilize them. I told you in respiration, oxygen cells utilize them. So here it is pharynx, then larynx, then trachea, then bronchi, bronchiole, alveoli, and then it moves inside from the capillaries, moves inside the bloodstream. And this is how it takes place. And similarly, the unwanted CO2 is being passed inside the alveoli, then from bronchi, bronchioles, to bronchi, to trachea, from larynx, pharynx, and nose, nasal passage, and then nostril, the CO2 is being removed and O2 is being taken up. I think I am clear here. So trachea, there are some specific parts of it. Trachea is actually made up of cartilages, so that it cannot collapse, because it's a tube, it needs to maintain its shape. Then bronchi is the pair of bronchi. These are bronchi, and they actually enter inside the each of the lung. So then they further divide into branches, and they are known as bronchioles. And then alveoli are the air sac in the end of the bronchiole, as you can see here, which are having very thin membrane and capillaries around it, blood capillaries around it, to take in the required gas, that is oxygen, and to give out not required gas, which is CO2. Now oxygen from the bloodstream along with the food enters inside the cell, different parts of the body, and enters inside the cell where it is being utilized by the cell. And the CO2 in return, cells give out the CO2, which was the byproduct of the respiration, if you remember, and it's been given out by the cell, which enters inside the bloodstream again, and from the similar passage it moves out in reverse order, it moves out through nostril. So here one more part is involved, and that is diaphragm. Now diaphragm is the portion which helps in the which is a membrane which separates this chamber from your abdominal cavity, right? This is abdominal cavity. So it separates this chamber from abdominal cavity so that there is a system can be maintained and there is no friction. So when the diaphragm moves, if you just try it out right now, if you breathe in, then the diaphragm, if you breathe in, then the lungs gets filled up with the air and the lungs expand and the diaphragm moves down. And then diaphragm comes back to its normal position when you exhale. So when you inhale, the diaphragm moves down and your lungs get expanded. And when the diaphragm moves up, when you exhale, okay, and lungs come back to their normal shape. So this is the part of respiration in human beings. Next, we'll talk about excretion. Do the in-text questions and go through them. So next, we'll talk about transportation in the next video. Thank you.